بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is our program Spirit of Values, a new episode. This is Dr. Tariq Rashid. We'll continue with the value of a team. Now, what are the different types of teams? What is the model that we usually start with in order to form a team? We will share a model called the FSNP model. The first stage is forming a team. How can we form a good team? Actually, we have to match the different talents to serve a common goal. And this is the role of a good leader. A good leader will form the team based on the mission required as well as the goal needed. Then when the team is formed, they start with a step called storming. In the storming, they start actually discussing, brainstorming together. Each one will provide his or her points of view, and the leader is facilitating the whole ideas in order to achieve. So this is what we call the storming phase in the team. Then, after a while, we will reach what we call norming stage, in which now we all understand our main job, our main task in a team. So this is a norm. We get the norm for the team, then we start performing to achieve a common goal. So this is, remember the model, FSNP is the model in which we build a good team: forming, storming, norming, and performing. Now, let's see different types of teams. One of the most important teams is what we call the balanced team. A balanced team, we mix the skills of different people in order to achieve a common goal. There are three major skills that are needed in an effective team. First, we need technical skills. For example, if I am forming an engineering team, we need professional engineers. But in addition to the technical skills in a team, we need what we call problem-solving skills. People with interpersonal skills can make decisions, can facilitate, can solve the problem, as well as we have a team working skills. When I believe in others and they believe in me, we can go. So combine the three different skills: technical, interpersonal, problem solving. We'll match all of these in order to go as one team in a balanced team. So the characteristics of a successful team: effective communication. And just remember, we discussed the concept of communication in one of the episodes. And communication is being able to deliver my message to the sender in a way that he or she understands the message. Then we behave according to this message in order to achieve a common task. We share the objectives. The objectives are well known for the whole team member, and each one understands his or her role and responsibility in the team. By this, we have a very good, successful team. The value of respect should always be there. So when the value of respect is there, the trust is there. When the trust is there, we achieve. Remember, we mentioned in the different episodes what we call the result chain of values. Respect will give trust. Trust will give confidence. Confidence, we can go and achieve. The highest level is the achievement. So, and then we'll become pride, and we are proud of our performance as a team, and we celebrate this as one team. So these are the actual characteristics of a successful team. Some people believe in working by themselves. So let's discuss why we should go as a team. First, companionship. Life is boring if you go by yourself. Even if you have the powerful technical managerial skills, all money in life, you need others. This is for sure. And always in some sort of life, you may have some sort of depression. We need support. Because of this, we need team around us. So support, companionship, and sense of belonging. If you believe in yourself, you belong to yourself. But when you believe in your team member, when you believe in your society, you feel a sense of belonging, being there, being part of the society, part of this family, part of this organization. never find this sense of belonging unless you believe in being a team member. Assistant with problems. You will never be able by yourself to solve all problems. We need assistance from others to help us with our problems that we face in life. And there are lots of problems in life. Sometimes social problems, technical problems. How can we act? Alone, we will never act. Sense of purpose even is achieved through the concept of a team. We just look to a player in a football game. Sense of belonging, sense of purpose. We have to go. We have to win. More ideas, always in a team. Even if you can give ideas by yourself, but you need more time. So let's believe in others. And because of this, we have to go in a team and strengthen our relationship. This is the concept of team. Are there disadvantages of working in a team? Yes, sometimes there are disadvantages. Sometimes conflict occurs. However, when conflict occurs, here is the team leader role to try to resolve the conflict between team members. If the conflict will enhance the performance, this is what we call positive conflict. But there is a negative conflict, we have actually to stop and think, is there a purpose of going with lots of conflict in this team? Sometimes we have excessive social atmosphere with the team. So sometimes they forget about the purpose and they start socializing. And here again, the contribution of the team leader to remind the team of the achieving the purpose. Sometimes some people like to be in individual case. And it's true, sometimes technical people prefer achievement by themselves. But this is in a very few situations. In logic, we should believe in strengthening all our skills in one direction and go as a team. Sometimes individuals may be reluctant to transfer their ideas or their skills. Here comes the role of a team leader to facilitate the issue of transferring and combining all of these, and we celebrate as one family. We reach a concept called team ID, team identity. What is the team identity? Each one of us has his or her identity, showing his name, his age, or date of birth. But the team also has an ID. It's part of the team, in which we have what we call means of identifying our specific team. You find this more in sport. This is X team. This is Y team. They have an ID. Even this is the team of this organization. This is the team of another organization. Sometimes they use what we call a dress code. Same dressing is giving what we call team identity. Sometimes the team logo. You'll find organizations have logos. What is a logo? A logo is showing what we call the identity of the team, identity of the organization. This is creating team ID. Sometimes specific locations, okay? Gulf areas, the Aegean, the southern parts, you'll find this is always there, and we can look at the different teams from different locations and geography. Uniform, sometimes the badges that we use, all of these will help in what we call the team ID. What are now the factors that influence a good team? Type of work, for example, some teams are highly technical because the problem or the main goal is technical. But sometimes we have what we call social team, where individuals are serving a social purpose. So the type of work will determine the team ID or sometimes the task of the team. Sometimes the size of the team. Usually they said the minimum number for a team is a 3, but the maximum number is open. And usually the average is from 4 to 6, with a good average of 5 forming a good team. This is the actually 80% of teams are around 5 members achieving a common purpose, defining and combining all these roles in order to achieve one purpose. Sometimes the background and the history. You'll find, for example, history may combine some teams together. So you'll find, for example, the Eastern culture, the Western culture. So you'll find the history may sometimes affect the concept of a team. Technology involved. And now we have what we call virtual teams. In the digitalizing world now, it's become easy to combine with different types of people in different locations, even in different times, using the virtual means of a team. And lots of organizations, big organizations, have different branches in different locations. How can they act as one team virtually? Also, the organizational culture is one of the most important factors affecting a team, and the members acting. All of these are factors that influence the team formation. How can we classify an effective team? Clear objective, clear goal. Each one understand his or her role, but support from top management and leaders, and we have adequate resources. Without resources, we will never achieve. At the end, result is directed towards what resources are available in order to achieve the purpose of a team. Also, identification. For example, this is the team leader. This is the expert of the team. Identification with giving different titles for the team members to serve the goal and objective. Stability and effective leadership. Without leaders, team will never achieve a purpose. Let's discuss deeply different types of teams. Sometimes we have what we call a project team. We have a certain project, and the project is always defined by a duration, start, end, achieving a certain purpose. This is what we call project team. At the end of the project, the team stops. It's working. So all members are ready to achieve a common purpose, which is in the project. Self-managed team is the best team when they are self-managed. But here, we have to have a level of expertise in the team members, and we allow them to manage themselves as a team, and only coordination and support come from top management for such a team, because the members are highly effective professional to achieve the common goals. Dispersed teams, when we have its member located in different locations, and as I mentioned, now we have virtual teams because of the distances sometimes, and don't have time or availability of moving from one place to another, we go through what we call virtual team, that we conduct team members and meetings in a virtual mode. Now, how can we motivate team members? Because at the end, in order to achieve a common purpose, we need to motivate people working as a team. So let's see team motivation. How can leaders motivate their team members? When you have the means but are not getting anywhere, seek appropriate associate and you will be lucky. Motivation is highly needed to achieve purpose. So let's discuss the following question. What motivates people? What do you think? What do they need? Leaders always understand the theory of motivation. Let me share with you how can we look together at the theory of motivation. Usually they said, according to Abraham Lincoln in 1943, he mentioned the concept of the hierarchy of needs. So if we look to the hierarchy of needs, we can understand the motivation theory. Maslow classify needs of people or members into 5 levels. First, there is what we call physical, biological needs. What do you mean by physical needs of people? So this is the pyramid of needs. If you understand the needs of people, you can easily motivate them. Physical needs, the need to eat, to drink, to dress, to sleep, to rest. This is very basic and strategic need for any one of us. If it is not satisfied, we cannot go for the higher level of needs. So physical needs. Then it's become what we call the security needs. Security needs. I am living a secure society. My family is secure, so security. And subhanAllah, إن قريش سورة قريش أطعمهم من جوع وآمنهم من خوف. Hunger first, then security comes. So there is a hierarchy of needs. If this is okay, we'll go to type 3, which is the social needs of people. Social needs, being part of a family, get married, being part of an organization, social needs. If this is okay, we'll go to what we call self-esteem need. Self-esteem, I should get higher salary, get higher position. So self-esteem, and the highest level is what we call self-actualization. This is the pyramid of needs. And always in each level, we have to motivate. How can leaders look to this and motivate people? By physical needs, organizational, we mean at least you should give the minimum salary to support the basic needs for people. What about security? They should feel job security. I'm secure in my job. I will continue in this organization. When people don't feel security in their jobs, they will never achieve a purpose, and this demotivation will occur. What do we mean? Social needs in organization? Let's go as a team. This is the value of team. Remember, together, everyone achieves more. This is the concept of a team, and always leaders believe in motivating their members. Self-esteem, give them promotions, enlarge their jobs, delegate them, empower them. Then they will reach the highest level, which is the self-actualization. When people reach this concept, the value of giving rather than taking. All these four levels, we always believe in taking, while when we reach here, we reach the value of giving. And giving, remember, is a very high level value. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.